Hello everyone, my name is Zura and I'm the Codeholic. On this channel, I share my 10 plus years of experience working as a professional software developer. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. In this video, I'm going to talk about 10 different PHP project ideas which can shift your portfolio on a next level. Although some of the projects are PHP specific, most of them can be also used for other programming languages. Before we start, hit the like button and let's jump into the video. The number one project is PHP MVC Framework. Nowadays, no one basically works without working with frameworks. And understanding how the framework works is fundamental. Building your own custom PHP MVC framework will help you a lot to understand how the most popular PHP MVC frameworks are working behind the scene, like Laravel or Symfony or E2. I have a whole series of building PHP MVC framework. If you're interested, I'm going to put the link in the video description. By building this project, you will understand what is MVC pattern, how it works, what are modules, controllers, how controllers and modules are connected to each other. So I really recommend build your own PHP MVC framework and put that in your portfolio. Project idea number two. It's a very common task to import and export data into application. At your job, no matter if you're going to work on PHP or on another programming language, you might have to import some data into the application, create the import functionality, or download the imported data in some sort of format like Excel or CSV. So I really recommend to work to create a basic project which can import the data from Excel, for example, parse the data and import that into database, and then create also export, which will generate Excel and make it challenging, make it complex, like create multiple sheets in the Excel. Try to put right there charts as well, because that's gonna, when you put that in your portfolio, that's gonna show the people who is gonna basically hire you that you know very well how to work data import and data export. Project number three is PDF generation. PDFs are used everywhere. So if you are gonna create an invoice, you will probably need to generate PDF. If you are gonna create, for example, a resume generator, you're gonna probably finally generate PDF. So create something on your own. Create an application which generates invoices or resumes, as I mentioned. The main point right here is that in your project, you need to show that you know how to generate complex PDF files and try to make the PDF as complex as you can, and definitely make that available and put this in your portfolio, because that's going to again show the people who is going to hire you that you know how to generate PDF files, which will probably be an essential task at every job. Project number three is an mini shopping cart functionality. I'm not talking about the fully functional e-commerce website. No, just create a products table and output the products on your website, then try to add them into the cart. So key point right here is that when you add the items into the cart, if the user is not authorized, you should save that information in cookies. And then whenever a user tries to authorize, you should move your cart items from cookies into the database. That's something really tricky, and you have to probably merge even cart items which you have in the cookie and you have in the database as well, because customer might have few items in the cookie and few items in the database. So you have to basically merge them into one. Project number five is email sending. It is as simple as that. At every job, you might have to send some kind of emails. So try to create a small application which will demonstrate how that you know how to send emails, how to provide body, subject, CC, BCC, how you can attach files. That's also a very important thing. Project number six, create simple CRUD application, but add also pagination, sorting, and filtering for all the fields basically which is possible. Some of the fields might be drop down values, like if you're building a customers table, you might have a country which should be a drop down for filtering. Okay, try to make the filtering inputs different types of inputs, like select and checkbox. For example, you want to filter all the customers who has status active, right? You tick the checkbox and it's going to search those customers. Okay, try to build this kind of project and put this in portfolio, because that's going to show everyone that you know how to work with a database, how to filter, how to sort the data, how to paginate your data. Project number seven is QR code generation. Nowadays, QR codes are used almost everywhere. So try to create a small application which will generate QR code for you. Try to generate for something meaningful. For example, you can put some URL right there and then generate QR code so that if someone scans that QR code, it will open that URL. Project number 8 is working with CURL, or as known as curl. So CURL basically is used to communicate with third-party APIs, and that's essential for any kind of backend developer, okay? Because you might have to integrate with something else, get some information, put some information there, try to create a simple application which will demonstrate that you know how to send information to third parties using CURL, how to get that information, how to also probably put a binary files, images or PDF files in the third party, or download those binary files using CURL and save it in your local file system. Project number 9 is customer registration. Basically, I think every PHP developer should know how to work with the customer, the input data, which comes from the user, the form data. So try to create a simple form. If you make this form more complex, that's going to be even better. So try to add there as much fields as you can, like the customer information, maybe billing addresses, shipping addresses. Try to put right there credit card information and validate all that kind of information. And then finally, make the information like saved in the database, or even you can put this in the session storage. So the main point right here in this project is that you know how to take the input data, how to sanitize, how to validate the data, and then save it somewhere. Project number 10 is event management application. Try to create a shared calendar on which anyone basically can add right their events, and then you save those events in the database. The main point right here is that you need to know how to work with dates and date times and different time zones. And that project, I think, is really good to demonstrate your skills how to work with dates and time zones. I think I have mentioned 10. And the last one, which is bonus, is to create and deploy a composer package. Every PHP developer basically needs to know how to work with composer. So create a composer package and make it available on your GitHub and deploy it on packages so that anyone basically can install that. And definitely prepare good README for your composer package, because that's another skill for every developer. The developer should be able to document his work. All right, guys, that's it all from me today. I hope you liked the video. If so, hit the like button and help me by sharing this video. If you're new to my channel, hit the subscribe button. Try to build these projects and put them in portfolio. That will definitely help you to stand out from everyone else, because you're gonna demonstrate that you have great skills. All right, I wish you good luck. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next time.